Hello children, so today we are going to discuss the first property of the of your chapter. So yesterday I have given some definitions of some numbers, so among that the rational number definition also given. I just want to recall the previous session definitions. So what is a rational numbers? Rational numbers are nothing but any number which can be represented in the form of p by q. So we have taken some examples also, 4 by 5, 5 by 6, 6 by 7, minus 5 by 8, 20, even 20 is also a rational number, 20 by 1. And what is the condition? Q does not equal to 0. So any number written in the form of P by Q can be called as rational numbers. P and Q are integers and Q does not equal to 0. So this is the definition what we have learned yesterday in the previous session. Now today in today's class, we are going to discuss some properties of rational numbers. So in our syllabus, the four properties are going to be discussed: closure property, commutative property, associative property and distributive property. So in this session we are going to discuss two properties. The first one is closure property. So what is the closure property? So here, before going to this, in this case, in the closure property or in every property, we have to discuss about the nature of rational numbers regarding four things. One is plus indicates addition, second indicates subtraction and multiplication and division. That means addition of rational numbers under closure property, subtraction of rational numbers under closure property, multiplication of rational numbers under closure property and division of rational numbers under closure property. Right? So now first I'll go for addition of rational numbers. Addition of rational numbers. So we have to check whether addition of rational numbers under is closure or not. So what is the point is that if the sum means addition, if the sum of two rational numbers is a rational number, then it is closure under addition. So this is the statement to be proved. That means we have to take any two rational numbers, we have to add it. If the result also a rational number, then we can say that addition of rational numbers is closure under the closure property. See how it's well. Now, so what is this statement? I repeat again. The statement is we have to take any two rational numbers, we have to add it. Then if the result is also a rational number, then we can say that it is closure under addition. Right? Now we'll go with some examples. So let us take any two rational numbers. So before going to do that, we have to recall addition of fractions. Suppose I'll give one beautiful method, very simple method. Suppose a by b is a fraction and c by d is one more fraction. A by b is a fraction and c by d is a fraction. So whenever you are going to do addition or subtraction, so very simple, first what we have to do is b into d, then next cross multiplication, a into d plus b into c. That means we have to this diagram, first one is multiplication of b and d denominators, then this and then this. First we have to write a b into d. Next what I have to do? A into d and c into b. So this method you have to follow if you are not perfect in LCMs. If you are perfect in LCM, you can do the LCM method. I'll tell both the methods. You can practice whichever you feel very easy. Right? Now let us check whether the rational numbers are closure under addition or not. First, I am taking one example, 7 by 4 and 5 by 8. Okay, suppose this is the two numbers, two rational numbers are taken. Rational number 7 by 4 P by Q form and one more P by Q form. Now let us check. 7 by 4 plus 5 by 8. So how to do the additions? In general, all the students will do one mistake. What they will do is 7 plus 5, 12. 4 plus 8, 12 they will write. This is wrong. This is totally wrong. Don't add the numerator, don't add the denominator. This is totally wrong. So don't do this type of mistakes. What we have to do is, I'll tell in two methods. First, I'll tell in LCM method. So first, what we have to take the denominators. What are the denominators? 4 and 8. LCM, I'm doing LCM. So what to take? I'll take two table. 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Again, I'll take two table. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Again, two table, 1, 1. So therefore, 2 into 2 into 2 into 1. So therefore, LCM is equal to what you will get? 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 1s are 8. The answer is 8. So therefore, the LCM is 8. Now, read this table. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8. How many times? 2. 2 into 7. What is the symbol inside? Plus. Now, read this table. 8 table. 8 1s are 8, 1 into 5. What you got? 2 7s are 14 plus 1 5s are 5 by 8. What is the answer? 14 plus 5? 19. 19 by 8. So look at this. 7 by 4 is a rational number. 5 by 8 is a rational number. Now 19 by 8 is rational or not? Yes, it is also a rational number. Because 19 by 8. 19 is one integer. 8 is one integer. And it was written in the form of P by Q. Therefore, closure property, now it is under a closure or not? Yes, it is a closure number. We have taken two rational numbers, we have added, and I got one more rational number. Right? Now this is the method 1, LCM method. Suppose if you are not perfect in LCM, then how to do this sum? We just follow that method. What is that method? Simply, very simple. First, multiply these two, B and D. A by B is 7 by 4, C by D is 5 by 8. First you multiply these two, how much you will get? 4 into 8. Now, according to that, what is the next step? A into D. That means 7 into 8. 7 into 8 plus, what is the next step? 5 into 4. Now, what is the answer? Yes, it? 7 8s are 56 plus 5 4s are 20 by 4 8s are 32. So 56 plus 20, what is the answer? 56 plus 20, 6, 7. How much? 76 by 32. Now 76 by 32 is a rational number or not means? Yes, it is also a rational number. Sir, you got previous another answer means? If you make it into short form, you will get the same answer. Look at this, I can cancel in 4 table. 4 8s are 32, I can write. And 76 can be written as 4 1s are 4, remainder is 3, 4 9s are 36. How much you got? 4 into 19. 4 4 gets cancelled, at last I got 19 by 8. Same answer. So, whether if you done in the LCM method or if you done in the normal method, you will get the same answer. Now, what is the conclusion? The conclusion is, if we take two addition, two rational numbers and we add it, we will get a rational number. That is the conclusion. So what I have to write? So therefore, conclusion. What I have to write the conclusion is, addition of rational numbers. What is the conclusion? Addition of rational numbers are closure, C-L-O-S-U-R-E, closure under addition. That is the first property. Got it? So now this is the conclusion. That means we have taken two rational numbers and we add it. Now, what is the second one? Second one is subtraction. So let us check whether the subtraction is closure or not. What method you have to follow? You have to follow the same method. What is the same method? You have to take two rational numbers, subtract it. If you get a rational number, then it is closure under addition, subtraction. Now I am going to take one more number, 4 by 5, 3 by 6. Right? So what I have to do? 4 by 5 minus 3 by 6. So similarly also don't say minus 4 minus 3, 1, 5 minus 6 is minus 1, don't write like that. For this also, you can do in two methods. One is normal method and LCM method. So in this case, I am explaining the normal method because some students are not good in, they are unable to do LCM properly. For that type of students, I am doing the normal method. If you are thorough with LCM, you can do with LCM. Now, the same point, if you are doing subtraction, what you have to do is same, everything will be same. The only change is minus. Now, what is the point? For first, what I have to do? I have to multiply these two. What is that? 5 into 6. Next step, 4 into 6. Minus. Next step is 3 into 5. Now, how much I will get? 4 6 are 24. Minus 3 5 are 15. By 5 6 are 30. And what is 24 minus 15? How much you will get? Yes, 9. 9 by 30. So therefore, 4 by 5 minus 3 by 6 is equals to 9 by 30. You can write in the short form also. What is the short form? 9 can be written as 3 threes. 30 can be written as 3 tens. 3 3 may cancel, you will get 3 by 10. Now, 4 by 5 is a rational number. 3 by 6 is a rational number. 9 by 30 also a rational number. So then what is the conclusion again here? What I have to write? Therefore, conclusion. Subtraction of rational numbers. Subtraction of rational numbers is closed under. Is closed, not under. So subtraction of rational numbers is closed. That means it is a closure property. We have to write. Now, what is the next one? Multiplication. This is very simple. So say multiplication also, we have to take two rational numbers and we have to multiply it. If we get a rational number, then it is closed under multiplication. Right? Same number, I am taking 5, one more. 5 by 6, 7 by 8. Now, what is this? Same, I have to do multiplication. 5 by 6 into 7 by 8. Now, what is the symbol here? Multiplication. So, whenever multiplication symbol is there, now a by b into c by d, you can multiply directly. That means, you can multiply the numerator with numerator, and denominator with denominator. So what is the answer? 5 into 7 by 6 into 8. 5 7s are 35, 6 8s are 48. Therefore, what is the answer in this case? 5 by 6 is a rational number, 7 by 8 is a rational number, 35 by 48 also a rational number. So what is the conclusion here? Therefore, rational numbers rational numbers are closed, C-L-O-S-E-D, closed under multiplication. That means this is the property. Right? So what I have to take? Take any two rational numbers, multiply it. If you get a rational number, then you can say that multiplication is closure. We can use the terminology closed, C-L-O-S-E-D, closed or closure. We can use both terminology. Next, division. So same number, what we have to do? We have to take two rational numbers and we have to divide it. If we get a rational number, then that is the closure under division. same I am taking 4 by 9 divided by 5 by 3. So how to remember this one is, I'll tell one formula. Whenever a fractions are there, when you are dividing the fractions, the simple logic is there, follow it. A by B divided by C by D. Suppose if you are doing a sum like this, then what you have to do is A by B into D by C. What is the difference? Which number we are going to divide, whenever you are multiplying, you have to take the reverse of the number. Its inverse you have to take. That means A by B divided by C by D can be written as A by B into D by C. Now what I have to write here? 4 by 9 into, I had read 3 by 5. 5 by 3 is going to be written as 3 by 5. Now what is the symbol we got? Multiplication. Then what I have to do? A into D by B into C. That means multiply these two. What is the answer it is? 4 by 3 by 9 by 5. So what is that? 4 threes are 12. 9 5s are 45. You can write in as a simpler form also. We can cancel in 3 table. 3 4s are 12. 3 15s are 45. 3 3 may cancel. You may get 4 by 15. So 4 by 9 is a rational number. 5 by 3 is a rational number. 4 by, what is the answer? Lastly, when we divide, 4 by 15 also a rational number. Then what we have to write? The conclusion. Therefore, rational numbers are closed under division. Right? So now we have to write one box. What is the properties that? How many we have done? We have done 4 points. What is that? Addition. Next, what we did? Subtraction. Next, what we did? Multiplication. Next, division. What is the answer? Yes or no? Yes. Addition is closed. Subtraction also closed. Next, multiplication also closed. Then next, division also closed. Yes, 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 yes. This is about closure property. Right? Now, I'll go for the second property of the rational number. This is the last property of your today's session. Next one is commutative property. C O M M U T A T I V E. What is that? Commutative property. Textbook, page number 6. If you are following the textbook, you can follow it. Page number 6. Now, what is in this case? In the previous case, we have taken any two rational numbers, we have add. If the result is a rational number, then we can say that it is a closure property. Now, in this case, what we have to do is, in the commutative property, the same we have to follow: addition, subtraction, same multiplication and division. In this case also, we have to assume, we have to check for 4 things. So the 4 things are, we have to check whether it is addition, and second thing is subtraction and multiplication and division also. Right? Now I'll go for your textbook examples in this case. So how to do in this case? So how to do is, first we have to take 2 rational numbers. What is that? We have to take 2 rational numbers. First, what we have to do is, we have to add first rational number to the second rational number. And second thing is, second rational number to the first rational number. So for example, I'll check it. 4 and 7. Now 4 plus 7. 7 plus 4. Is there any difference? 4 is added to 7. Now 7 is added to 4. In this case, 4 is added to the 7. But the answer is same, 11 and 11. That means if we add first number to second number, or second number two first number, the result is, if the result is same, then we can say that it is commutative. Otherwise, it is not commutative. Right? Let us check whether the result is equal or not. So let first number, I am going to take it as a. A is 4 by 5. And second number, I am going to take it as 3 by 4. Now, first I am checking a plus b. That means, I am adding first number to the second number. And what is the answer? It is 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4. And what is the result? And what is the next step? 5 into 4. Look at this. It is a plus symbol. In for plus symbol and minus symbol, we have to follow one method. For multiplication and division, we have to follow another method. So first multiply these two. Next, 4 into 4. Next, plus 3 into 5. What is the answer? 4 fours are 16 and 3 fives are 15 by 5 fours are 20. What is the answer? 16 plus 15. How much you will get? 16 plus 15. 5 plus 6, 11. 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. So it is 31 by 20. So what is the answer? It is 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4 is equals to 31 by 20. This is the condition when A is added to B. What is the next step? We have to check B plus A. That means this time we have to reverse it. So what is the next step? 3 by 4 plus 4 by 5. Now what is the next step? Addition is there. Then what I have to do? Symbol 4 into 5. Next 3 into 5 plus 4 into 4. What is the answer? 3 5s are 15 plus 4 4s are 16 by 4 5s are 20. So 15 plus 16, we got 31. Same, 15, 16. 6 plus 5, 11. 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. How much we got? 31 by 20. So what is the answer? It is 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4 is equals to 31 by 20. Look at this. If we add 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4, we got 31 by 20. We add 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4. Reverse. So 3 by 4 plus 4 by 5. We got 31 by 20. So, what is the conclusion? How to write the conclusion is 3 by 4 plus 4 by 5 is equals to 4 by 5 plus 3 by 4 is equals to, what is the answer? 31 by 20. So therefore, what is the conclusion is that A plus B is equals to B plus A. This is the statement. That means, whenever we add both the rational numbers in any method, you will get the same answer. So for this, how to write in AND? Your textbook is given. I will explain. This is the symbol. This is the symbol given. This symbol is nothing but for all. For all, A comma B belongs to Q. What is Q here? Rational numbers. Mean A and B are any rational number. Then what is the point? A plus B is equals to B plus A. So how to read this one? This is the symbol for all. For all A comma B, how to read? Belongs to Q. Q is nothing but rational numbers. So then A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is the condition, commutative property for under addition. Next, second thing is, what is the second thing? Subtraction. So, we'll go for subtraction. Let us check. Now, before going to subtraction, I'll ask one question, some doubts. What is the question is? Minus 5 by 6, 5 by 6. These two are equal or different? Minus 5 by 6, 5 by 6. These two are equal or different? So what's your answer is, sir, only minus is there, it is both are equal means these two are not equal, because 5 is a positive integer, 6 is a positive integer. But in this case, 5 is negative integer, minus 5 is negative integer, and 6 is positive integer. These two are not equal. 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. These two are equal or not equal means these two are not equal. Right? So remember this point, because 9 of the students will write both are same. That is wrong. Then next. So just some properties are there. If both minus are there, minus symbols are there, what we have to do, you know, we have to add and keep minus symbol. If one plus, one minus symbol is there, what we have to do? We have to subtract the smaller number from bigger number and we have to keep the minus symbol. For example, 6 minus 5. What is the answer? Plus 1. Why plus 1 is nothing symbol is given, which is plus symbol. 6 minus 5, which is the bigger number? 6. From 6, 5 has to be taken off and the symbol of 6 is plus 1. If the same question is given, 5 minus 6. So what is the answer? Don't write 1, it is minus 1. Why I should write minus 1 is, if 1 plus, 1 minus is there, what we have to do is, we have to subtract the smaller number from bigger number and we have to keep the symbol of bigger number. Now tell me what is the answer of 14 minus 20? Yes, 14 minus 20 is minus 6. 18 minus 12, what is the answer? So 18 is bigger symbol, 18 is bigger number and 12 is smaller number. Answer is plus 6. What is the answer of 10 minus 30? What is the answer? It is minus 20. Why minus 20? 10 is smaller number having plus symbol, 30 is bigger number. Whenever you are subtracting, we have to subtract the smaller number from bigger number and we have to take the symbol of bigger number. Now we'll go for the sum. Now in this case, I'll take A 4 by 5 and B 1 by 2. My wish. I'll take any numbers. You can also take any number. No need to take these only. You can take any numbers. And what is the first step? What we have to do? Subtraction na A minus B. So tell me those steps. 4 by 5 minus 1 by 2. What is the next step? 5 into 2. Next step is 4 into 2 minus 1 into 5. 1 into 5. So 4 2s are 8 minus 5 by 10. So what is 8 minus 5? 3. 3 by 10. So this is the answer when we have done A minus B. What is the next step? Reverse it. B minus A. And what is the B minus A? 1 by 2 minus 4 by 5. What is the next step? 2 into 5. What is the next step? 1 into 5 minus 4 into 2. What is 1 into 5? 5. And 4 into 2? 8. 8 by 10. Look at this, if nothing is symbol is given, we have to assume it as plus symbol. Right? So plus 5 minus 8. Now what I have to do? I have to subtract the smaller number from bigger number and we have to keep the symbol of bigger number. So the answer is minus 3 by 10. Now look at this. In the first case, we got 3 by 10. In the second case, we got minus 3 by 10. Now both are equal or not? They are not equal. So therefore, what we have to write? A minus B does not equal to B minus A. That is the point. That means, now it is commutative or not means, subtraction of rational numbers is not commutative. So how to write? Symbolize. What is this symbol? For all A comma B belongs to Q. What is Q? Rational numbers. What I have read the statement is, A minus B does not equal to B minus A. This is the point. Right? So, A minus B, we got 3 by 10. B minus A, we got minus 3 by 10. So, therefore, it is not equal. Next. What is the third property? Third one, we have to check it. We have to check multiplication. So, same, take two rational numbers and multiply from first and second. Now, in this case, I am going to take A as 9 by 5 and B as 10 by 6. Now, multiplication. What is the first condition? A into B. So, what I write? 9 by 5 into 10 by 6. So, now look at this. It's a multiplication. So, multiplication, what I have to do? I have to multiply the numerator with numerator, denominator with denominator. So, what is that? 9 into 10 is 90. 5 into 6 is 30. How much I got? 90 by 30. What is the second case? B multiplied with A. Then in this case what I write? 10 by 6 into 9 by 5. And what is that? 10 into 9 by 6 into 5. And what is that? 10 into 90? 90. 6 into 5, 30. Look at this. Both answers are same. Then what I have to write? A multiplied with B is equal to B multiplied with A. So then what is the final statement? This is the symbol for all. A comma B belongs to Q. A into B is equals to B into A. That's all. This is the property of multiplication under commutative property. And last, divisions. Say, take two numbers. A is equals to 2 by 5 and B is equals to 7 by 3. Now, first what we have to do? A divided by B. That means 2 by 5 divided by 7 by 3. So, division, what we have to do with the division? We have to transform into the multiplication. Then what you'll get? 2 by 5 into 3 by 7. This is the difference you have to remember. Just previously I told you, what is the formula? A by B divided by C by D can be written as A by B into D by C. Now, what is the next step? 2 into 3 by 5 into 7. What is that? 2 3s are 6, 5 7s are 35. This is the answer. Next, check it, reverse it. What will you get? B divided by A. What is the answer? 7 by 3 divided by 2 by 5. What is the next step? 7 by 3 into, what I have to do? Reverse, 5 by 2. Next, 7 into 5 by 3 into 2. How much I got? 5 is 35 by 6. Look at this. These two are equal means they are not equal. One is 6 by 35, second one is 35 by 6. Both are different. Then what I write? A divided by B does not equal to B divided by A. So what is the final conclusion? Therefore, for all, A comma B belongs to Q. A divided by B does not equal to B divided by A. Is the property. So what is the commutative property? It's equal or not means it is not equal. So therefore the final conclusion, box representation. What is the box representation? Take a box with four rows. So what is the first row? What we have done? We have done addition. Addition, we got yes or not? Yes. Next one is subtraction. Subtraction, we got yes or no means no, because what we got? A minus B does not equal to B minus A. For multiplication we got yes, and for division we got no. A divided by B does not equal to B divided by A. This is the point. So overall this is the conclusion, right? So these are the two properties what we have discussed here. So today's assignment, so after watching this video we have to do the given work. Today's assignment is check the properties of क्लोजर एंड कॉमिटेटिव ऑफ रेशनल नंबर्स अंडर एडिशन सब्ट्रैक्शन मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन विथ योर ओन एग्जाम्पल ओन एग्जाम्पल्स आई गिवन सम एग्जाम्पल्स नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज टेक ए इज इक्वल्स टू वन वैल्यू and b is equals to one value and you have to check it. So this is your assignment. So if you have any doubts you can check in the test book also. So if you have any doubts you can ask the doubts in the WhatsApp, you can clarify your doubts through that. So that's all. This is for today's session and we'll meet in the next session. Thank you.